is Dr. Sheila Tikku speaking about magnetic properties of transition metal complexes for class 3rd year. The study of magnetic properties plays an important role in understanding of transition metal chemistry. For most of the transition metal compounds, especially the complexes, the magnetic data help us understanding the geometry and nature of bonding. Origin of magnetism. Though the only forces operating between stationary charges are electrostatic, it can be known experimentally that magnetic forces are associated with moving charges. Thus, if an electric current, which is a flow of electrons, be passed through a wire coiled around a core, the field so produced behave as if it was due to a magnet. Considering the classical model of an atom, the motion of electron around nucleus can be compared to flow of electric current. The following types of two magnetic movements are associated with each electron in an atom. Number one, orbital magnetic movement. Due to orbital motion of electron. Second is the spin magnetic movement due to spinning of electrons. That means the electron moves on its axis. The magnetic interaction which is placed is done through the situation of the electron. Due to these type of magnetic movements, there are different types of magnetic behaviors. On the basis of behavior, they are classified into paramagnetism, diamagnetism, and the third is ferromagnetic and antiferromagnetism. Number one is the paramagnetic magnetism. According to paramagnetic studies, when a compound is placed in between the North Pole and the South Pole of a magnet, the number of lines passing through the paramagnetic substance get attracted to the North and the South Pole. The greater the number of unpaired electrons, the greater will be the paramagnetism. The paramagnetism is a property of substance with permanent and definite magnetic moment, and it is associated with unpaired electrons. The main example of this is chromium. The next type of property with which we can deal is diamagnetism. When zinc metal is placed in the magnetic field, then the intensity of external magnetic field is less in zinc metal than in vacuum. Thus, the substances which decrease the intensity of a magnetic field are known as diamagnetic substances. Magnetic lines of forces avoid these substances. Thus, they repel the magnetic field, whereas the paramagnetic substances attract the magnetic field. Diamagnetic properties of substances is due to the orbital motion, and paramagnetism is due to the electronic motion of the compounds or the metals and the elements. Ferromagnetism and antiferromagnetism. In the compounds discussed so far, we assume that the compound is either attracted or repelled by the magnetic field. When the magnetic species are very close, when they sometimes get converted into permanent magnets when being placed in a paramagnetic field. Such type of compounds are known as ferromagnetic substances, in which iron is the main source of ferromagnetism. Even a moderately strong field may suffix this purpose at higher field strength. The susceptibility can increase no further, and the crystal was reached saturation. Such type of compounds in which the spins are in one side, they become permanently ferromagnetic. In antiferromagnetic, we have two types of spins. They can be in one direction and they can be in one and opposite direction. The magnetism is directly concerned with needle temperature. If a graph is plotted between the magnetic susceptibility and temperature, in normal paramagnetism, the paramagnetism decreases with increasing temperature. Ferromagnetism remains stable, but after passing on Curie point, it also decreases. The antiferromagnetic compounds, as the temperature increases, the magnetic property increases, and after placing or after surpassing the nil point, the antiferromagnetic property starts decreasing. This is shown in the figure 3.2.